Okay. Are you listening, you disgusting goon loser? Are you all hot and horned up?
Okay, fellas. We got a beautiful woman on the way to finish you off, but just to get things started here, if you're sitting at a computer at a public library, in the computer in your family room, even a computer by yourself, you're going to want to take your pants all the way off. You want to take your shirt all the way off. Get fully nude. Start touching your penis. Don't click off the episode yet. A beautiful woman is on the way to guide you through this. Just hang out with us for just one more moment. You're going to want to touch your penis. Try pinching your ball sack. See if that feels good.
And we've got him. Okay.
All right, we got him. I'm so sorry you had to witness.
Yeah.
Why are you sorry?
It's just really embarrassing that that's what we're doing to keep the lights on. But unfortunately, jerk off instructions is all anybody is interested in.
I think you should get sex work is work.
Okay.
That's true. I keep saying.
You guys are hard workers.
We were nervous about having to do this in front of you.
Me?
Yeah.
Look how I'm sitting.
I wish you could come and. Wish you could tell that to my dad.
Yeah.
He is humiliated that I'm doing jerk off instructions online for a living.
He's listening.
But, you
and
know.
He's whacking it.
He's listening. That's how you know you really got a hook.
His problem with the jerk-off instructions was that they weren't good enough, really.
Yeah,
he wasn't
that
mad
I'm bad
that
at it.
That is probably that is for the frustrating part.
Like, but, you expect me to come from this?
Yeah.
But I'm doing my best, and it's all anyone wants
I'm listening to,
hear.
To what you say.
I'm trying my best, Dad.
I'm following your instructions.
Who's going to come to this? You're getting a voicemail from your dad? Listen to your latest podcast. Who the fuck is going to come to that? Yeah.
I was soft as a wet noodle.
Oh, for the guys, we are here with...
A guy.
An
angry guy.
One of the top guys.
One of the top guys.
One of the top angry guys.
Wild Bill.
Yes.
William Hannigan.
Wild
That's
Bill
true.
William
Hot
Hannigan.
Off of recording
off.
An album.
Yeah.
How'd it go?
Done. It's good. It was good.
Fun?
No, but yeah. Like good. Like rewarding, but
yeah.
Yeah, it went. The shows went good. And, nothing went wrong, so it's like not funny to really to talk about, you know.
Nice,
so cool. Like,
so yeah, all you guys can check that out at some point.
Yeah, check it out. I might watch it and just spaz, like delete it.
That's Martin Scorsese says that though. He says if you're the first cut of your thing doesn't make you want to like go to your car and blow your head off, you didn't do it right.
Really?
Yeah, he said that's supposed
to
happen.
What happens if you want to blow your head off before you see it?
That's normal, too.
That's normal?
There's a point, basically, 5 years after it's done where you're like, oh, nice. But the entire process should be really bad.
Have you done an album before?
You don't even know
before?
How to run a camera.
Or was that your first album?
That was the first. I did another album like kind of like during the pandemic with Bobby, and it was like more of like an EP, and there was like 20 people there, and that was like okay. But this is like the first like album. Like the other one I didn't tell anybody about.
Oh,
I just
okay,
sent
yeah.
to SiriusXM to make some money.
Nice.
And they gave me a little bit.
Nice.
Give me a couple plays, little pity plays.
Nice. You sent it to Howard Stern?
No. This guy named Ben Miner.
Nice.
Yeah.
Send him to Howard. Hey, Howard, this is 45 minutes of me riding a Sibian. If you want to play this on the air.
I don't know how you want to cut it up, but...
I think it'd be good for your show.
You kind of need the start to understand the middle.
Like,
but the middle is the most.
About 25 grand on the Sibian, so I'm going to need you to hit me at least 30 for this, Howard.
Anyways, hope you read these submission forms.
That would be... hey, Howard, I custom fitted a Harley engine onto a Sibian. And then I wrote it for 2 straight hours and recorded it. It's crazy. It hurt. I
hurt
can't
so
walk.
Bad. I'm actually passing away slowly. So if you could just,
I got a lot of internal bleeding.
Just give it to my kids, I guess. Whatever royalties I make off this.
I've been laughing at the idea of a Harley Davidson Sibian for 3 days. I have not stopped thinking about it.
I think that's what they are.
Like, yeah, isn't that kind of what it is?
Well, what I'm picturing is like just the engine block of a Harley with a Sibian on top, and then
what
maybe
is a Sibian?
It's like one of those like horse saddle search, things that you use for sex.
Oh, that's so fast! You pulled it up so quick.
Yeah,
so it's like that type of.
So there's a penis on it, or like a doorknob.
I didn't actually realize this is what it looked like.
That's how you shift gears on the top there.
I didn't realize it had. I thought it was more like like an electric horse thing, you know, at a bar.
Yeah, I kind of pictured like the Wii mat.
Because I've seen them rock back and forth. I guess I just never saw the full penetration.
Wow, yeah, that's...
There's a book there. Tied to their Sibian, they orgasm me into submission.
You connect
cool.
your Kindle to the Sibian.
Well, I get two things done at once. I can read a book.
Yeah,
and,
so you can read an erotic novel.
Yeah.
While you're
the 48 laws of torqued. Power.
We're actually just checking out because there's
my Sibian.
There's
just
cool 4X stuff.
Books. Amway.
Like back in the day, yeah. There wasn't cool Sibian style stuff for dudes.
Wasn't.
I don't think so. I think that's a newer thing. Because Howard Stern was having chicks on the Sibian like 30 years ago.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, that was a thing he'd do on his show.
But now there's cool stuff
that's
like
pretty
this.
Dope.
We have this now.
It'd
which
be
I
tough for talk radio. Just watching a girl. Oh, shit.
This thing I thought
this
was
thing jamming
first,
yeah, it does.
Yeah. And it looks like one of those things you can like scuba dive with to make it go faster.
Yeah, it looks like a scuba dive like film camera.
It'd be so if I worked on a diving crew, I would swap out one of my guys' little
That'd
jets
be
for
so
that.
Funny.
He gets down there and just
guy does the longest free dive of all time. He comes back up, he's like, "You get all that?" And you're like, "I came."
I mean, I guess people can't see it, but it's a extremely high powered pocket pussy.
Really?
Yeah. Why does it need that much power?
But I feel like it's going back too far. Like,
yeah, there has to be a bottom out setting.
Yeah,
you know?
like that. Yeah,
inch and a half is really what I need.
Yeah, but I mean, your liability issues would be zero. Zero liability.
Yeah.
No one is going to break their dick on that and then like report you.
No, yeah.
Yeah, because like, oh, I set it on the 10-inch setting and it snapped my dick clean.
No,
half.
I don't have a
No, I'm
good
trans.
Dick. Now I'm in between a boy and a girl. I got like a fucking Bugs Bunny broken nose on my dick.
Yeah, this thing hit the top of my dick and my dick went around my body three times like Daffy Duck's bill.
Yeah. He looks like Yosemite Sam after explosion.
You imagine finding that under your buddy's bed?
Or you just go in yes. into the living room, they've got that like hanging on the wall.
Oh, it's drying.
Pull it out of the dishwasher.
Yo, where should I put my plate? Oh, just in the dishwasher, and it's that in there.
With
running.
Like 50 other dildos.
There's a lot of functionality to that. Like you could use that to like ram fence posts in.
That's
true. You could. That's a good explanation to your wife.
It's for the fence I'm building.
It's actually just for hammering nails.
Harry, we have a condo.
Well, I'm working on the fence around the... I'm trying to get the contract for the condo board.
Well,
do a
you
fence.
Know how my hammering arm's been recently from all the work I've been
I
doing.
Blew it out.
Fucking jacking off. God damn it, Cheryl. Just let me jack off with this scuba machine.
We're only a couple years away from like having... From this not only being like a normal household item, this plus like a number of other accoutrements. Being completely like an X, that'll be like an Xbox.
You think so?
I think so.
Yeah,
I don't think
the
it's
Xbox
ever gonna.
Will have an attachment like that.
I think we're trying to solve the problem of male loneliness, and the answer is pussy. But
yes, but
it's
not
that.
This
it's not light. It's not like plastic.
Have you tried this thing?
I mean, no. But I also have the opposite problem. I'm like, I just want to get away from my girlfriend right now. The opposite problem of male loneliness. What is it? Female smothering.
You have dad syndrome.
I do, dude.
Do you have a garage? I feel like you need a garage where you can just go hammer nails. And
you have your car.
That would be nice. I do have my car.
Start putting 2x4s in your car and cutting them.
All right, I'm gonna go do some work and then go play with power tools on 2x4s.
My car's fucked up right now. So like, there's exhaust coming into the car.
Cool.
And I just rolled the windows up on the way over here. So I was just like, I hope I wanted to make it here, but I wanted to like change my mood a little bit.
Yeah. Get
did
a little
not work.
No?
No.
It just makes you a little sleepy.
It just made me and angry that my car is leaking fumes into the body.
There's one thing more fun than having a car with a mechanical problem, and that's having to daily drive a car with a mechanical problem that you haven't fixed yet.
That does suck.
My car's leaking oil right now. As
it
we
is.
Speak, it's leaking a little bit of oil on the ground.
It's just like dripping it?
Yep, I leave a little... My car's wet, dude, all day. Just leaves little puddles wherever it goes, like a slot, like a slug.
I've been here.
Can you put some like, putty on that or something?
Basically, that's what I'm going to do. Yeah, I'm going to chew 5 gum and pick it all around where it's leaking and be fine.
But just 5 gum?
Yeah, yeah. I'm not... What am I going to buy, silicone?
I thought you were going to say bisexual.
What am I, bisexual?
I mean, cars, despite all their problems, cars are pretty great. There's nothing like sitting by yourself in a parking lot and like eating fast food in your car.
Oh,
it just hits different.
Peeling out.
Yeah. Later, losers.
It's fun to drive. I don't know if you guys have ever like driven while you're like horribly depressed or like about to cry.
Oh, yeah.
And then you're just like driving like you're angry, but there's nothing inside of you.
Yes.
Like, taking corners like that and letting your head hit against the window.
Wow. Yeah. That's a really great male experience.
Yeah. Just your face is dead.
Like right,
you're going through the motions, like you're passing a Portuguese family and like flipping them off, but there's nothing. You don't get anything.
But it's
out
like
of it.
Slow and sad.
But like when I like I right before I have to go get my like eye surgery done, which I was all freaked out about. I was just I was driving home and I was like, ah, fuck it. So I was just driving like 100 in like a 60 zone. My music cranked all the way up. And it felt cool as hell.
On your way to an eye surgery?
Yeah.
Can't do this when my eyes are better.
Yeah, I was like, this could be my last opportunity to do this. If this goes wrong,
last
I won't,
blind rage drive.
I won't be able to speed and listen to really loud music and smoke cigarettes in my car anymore. So I got to get it all in right now.
Everything blurry.
Yeah.
I'm going through hyperspace right now. It's a school zone. Hyperspace school zone.
Yeah.
Imagine the post nut clarity on that machine. Like once you butt, and then all you hear is like boop, 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 boop.
I mean, I kind of feel like it would be brutal on any like pocket pussy esque device.
Like the clarity after
the post nut clarity.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Like after you come in one of these things, it's like, oh, now I gotta clean it.
I feel like it has more to do with what you're thinking about while you're doing it. You know what I mean?
Maybe.
I feel like that has more to do with the horrible shame.
Because I would feel pretty bad after one of those, I think.
I think immediately after using that, I would look at my like credit card history and be like, man, that was like $289. God damn it,
I feel
it,
like probably...
It's just above that, OnlyFans. Yeah,
My guess is like greater than 50% of all pocket pussies get used one time. And then never cleaned out and like put in a plastic bag and tied up. And like put in a corner of a closet or thrown out. Or
left on a doorstep.
That's how we treat women.
Ain't that fucked
we
up?
We just tie them up, put them in a closet, never look at them again.
It is funny to use a pocket
What's
pussy.
What's that smell? Oh shit! God damn it!
It's actually really funny to use a pocket pussy once and then leave it on a like the doorstep of a fire hall, like it's an orphan.
They all come like down the boys.
Like it's raining and you knock and then like they open the door and no one's there and there's just a pocket pussy.
The whole neighborhood's burning down and the fire door will not open. It just won't open. You're banging on it. Like, what are those guys doing? Are they making spaghetti?
Yes.
Yeah, they are. One guy's making spaghetti. Everybody else is jacking off.
All right, when this is done, I get on that, right? That was the deal.
Yo, fuck you.
Just come on, bro. You got to share.
I'm so jacked up right now.
Dude.
Burns the firehouse down.
Yeah, that'd be so fun.
I don't know. I feel like the clarity of the... Like, I don't even... I don't know. I'm not well right now, but mostly I think like when I jerk off, I'm like clearing my throat. That's what it is to me. I'm like... I'm already like my baseline of like I'm a pig.
But have you ever used a $500 power tool to jerk off?
No, that's the thing is I don't love myself enough to invest that amount of money.
Because I feel like if you use one of those, you would feel really grim afterwards.
Yeah. Like
is my guess.
The thoughts I think would be dark.
The bruises on your hips from the
like the fact you'd have like kind of noodly arms from holding this fucking. Crazy machine. You'd just be like sore in weird places and you'd be like, oh god,
I don't
Jesus.
Even know what to tell people to look up to get an image of this, but it's like a pocket pussy attached to like a jackhammer.
Yeah basically
spot to put your phone at the top.
Yeah, you haven't seen that part, but there is a phone clip at the top.
Yeah,
so
that's
the best part of the video.
He's flicking the pussy lips. Can they hear it? They could probably hear it.
Oh, yeah. He's got his mic up to the speaker.
I like the sound of that. Oh, my God.
Just pop your phone.
Yeah, it's like an unboxing video. He's like testing, touching all of it, and then he puts the phone on both hands, and then
my favorite shot is from the bottom when it's like going like at the camera like this. These pussy lips.
This is what your dick will see. This is what your dick eye is gonna look down.
Pee hole cam.
POV your dick.
Yeah.
It's like that scares my penis.
Yeah.
I wonder how much these things cost.
I don't know. I'm also delaying any sort of like sexual perversion as long as I can, so I can hopefully just make it the rest of my life without having to do fucked up stuff to get myself off. You know what I mean?
Ah, yeah, because it is a snowball.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, the early you start being like a freak, the more crazy it's going to be when you're like older.
Yeah, you just don't enjoy just regular
jacking off.
I was going to say pussy, but...
Like, we've looked at some pretty wild like alternatives to jacking off. Like, there's guys who like electrocute their penises with elaborate contraptions that they've made.
Yeah.
Stuff like that.
We actually...
What's that Reddit? Is that CBT?
Cock and ball torture, yeah.
Oh,
it's
yeah,
crazy.
Yeah.
It's crazy. We actually just watched a video this week of a guy who was buying panties on the internet. And then the video is actually choice. His wife is sleeping, so he's in the like ensuite bathroom with a camera on a tripod whisper reviewing these panties he bought on the internet.
That's so hot.
It's crazy.
That's
he's
so
like,
hot.
He's wicked out of breath. He's like, but like, he's like roided out too. So he's like, keeps getting excited and having to like bring his voice down.
He's big and he pulls out these little panties.
Yeah. And then he sniffs them and it's crazy.
And it's like 12 minutes long. He posted it on a bodybuilding forum.
Yeah. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. It was on bodybuilding.com.
My wife would be devastated if she knew what I was doing. But so she's asleep right now. That's why I'm whispering.
That's smart though, delaying any sort of perversion. Cause yeah,
I don't know if it's smart, but it's like I'm just like I don't really like the whole like try everything.
That's fair.
Cause I did that, and I just started doing cocaine.
Yeah, fair enough.
So then it's like, I don't know if I. Yeah, I just don't want to. Like, so now what I do is like I'll watch porn. I'll watch like, I used to watch porn. Now I don't really watch porn. I'll like look at like just still images like of like naked girls.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
But then I stop looking at them, and then I just. Finish like my
like
own.
You kind of plant a seed and nurture
a
little.
100%. It's like, well, you know when like a father's teaching a kid to ride a bike without training wheels, and they're holding them, and then they let them go.
This is a crazy analogy
and
for jacking
just,
off.
Yeah, but it's perfect.
Yeah, you're kind of like
so I'm like a father to my own dick.
Regressing almost. So that's like when I was a kid, and you'd like see like you know one guy's dad has like a nudie calendar in the garage or something.
Yeah,
like my dad used to have. He used to buy those tattoo magazines.
Oh yeah,
and they always had like crazy. Crazy like chicks with like face tats and stuff.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that like, I would like steal them as like a 5 year old and be like, nice.
And you just look at them and then you hold it in your mind for years.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then it creates you as a guy.
I love that. I love that. I like strengthening my mind.
Because I think that
it's fun to like destroy an entire industry with just your head,
with your brain.
Your brain. You're like,
I can just imagine that actually.
Yeah, like you don't go to movies either.
Yeah,
I can think about it.
I've seen Mission Impossible 9.
Yeah, I've seen
he's
the
on
trailer.
A bicycle.
I can probably fill out the blanks in my head. Like, Tom Cruise is cool. He does some cool shit.
You just show up to the movie theater, buy some Twizzlers, and then just stand right in front of the theater door and just be like, whoa. That was.
Nice.
That was crazy.
Whatever I did in here.
Probably cooler.
Way more nuts.
Yeah, because you can skip all the shit you don't like.
Yeah.
You can skip all the dialogue.
Yeah, I'm trying to get to a point that when I finally have dementia and I can't move my body and like I'm in a prison of my own mind,
yeah,
that it's actually like a pretty good time.
Why are you so confident you're going to get dementia?
Well, unless I die before that.
Is it inevitable, you think?
It's almost 100% inevitable that you will get dementia.
Really?
Like if you live long enough?
100%.
Damn.
I don't know that. But it is like it's like extremely likely that you will start getting dementia.
I guess the ratio of old people I know who are not out to lunch versus living on Mars basically is...
Well, I mean like the guys who use this basically have dementia. Like they don't speak to anybody else.
No.
And like if you tried to have a conversation with them, you'd be like, oh, get the fuck away from me. And it's like, imagine what old people are going. Like everybody's like, you smell wrong because you're dying. So they want to be away from you. So it's like, even if you don't actually have dementia, like you're alone, you're isolated, you know, you don't, everyone's gay now and you're like, oh, I can't say anything.
What are these kids doing?
Yeah.
I actually saw an old guy today at work. He was just wandering a parking lot looking at cars. I was like, damn.
That's the kind of shit you got to do.
To stay sharp.
Stay sharp, look at cars.
It's that or just be in at home looking at like the paintings you bought 40 years ago.
Well, the problem with current old people,
yeah.
It's like they don't even know how to use the internet.
No.
Because like when we get old, we'll still have online.
They're going to take it from us.
At least we can hang out online.
You think
they're
so?
Going to take it from us.
Yeah.
They already have to some extent.
Yeah, they make platforms that make it feel like you're on the internet, but you're not actually on the internet. It's just giving you a bunch of shit that they are like, oh, this is going to like lead him towards this ad.
That's true.
And it filters you to like, like
I'm pointing at the jack off
websites now.
Yeah.
But I used to find wild shit on Google. Like you do a Google search and like one page down, it would be like random
anything.
Schizophrenic geniuses with their like their own website, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you can't find that shit anymore.
No. The last one we found it because a guy, MasonicMadness.com, was a local guy who writes his website URL on like dumpsters and stuff.
Yeah, he wrote it on the dumpster behind my work.
And we checked
rocks.
It out. It's very cool.
What's
but
on there?
It's Masonic Madness.
Just
oh, I've seen that
yeah.
on dumpsters.
Yeah,
I just never Googled it.
It's crazy.
The only way you can advertise that kind of stuff. Anymore.
Yeah,
what is on there? Like
it's literally like an insanely. It's like a scrawl.
But
text.
He had like a huge, like a giant essay he wrote about how the COVID scamdemic was going to go down. But he wrote it in like March 1st. 2020, like the first week of the
Whoa.
Pandemic, he
like
wrote this,
when
like,
it was like coming out in China, he wrote this
like huge
exactly
thing.
How it happened.
Maybe I did look this up.
Fuck. He's kind of legit.
Where was it hosted?
I think it was just Masonic Madness.
Is it Madness or Mayhem?
It's the same guy buying panties online
on bodybuilding.
Yeah,
forum.
He's being very quiet. He's like, "This is what's gonna happen over COVID." If my wife found out that I was talking like this, she would be fucking devastated.
That's me.
I might have to refer
now.
To the.
Don't tell her that I spent.
Refer to the. Dumpster by my work.
35?
35 bucks.
Oh, that's fine.
It's okay.
That's
well,
good.
When you have 75, it's not the best.
Yeah, I guess if you're think about it in percentages.
If you want to get math about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, if you want to talk about half.
But now I have cool vases.
I think I'm realizing now I lost a $100 check.
Oh,
right before I left.
Damn.
I don't think I'm mad at my girlfriend at all.
No, I don't think so. I think you're mad about losing a $100 check.
I think everything I said, though, was right.
Yes. Yeah. I don't. Yeah. Everything you were saying, I was like, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's reasonable.
Reasonable things. But
just
yeah, you
unreasonable
are.
Unreasonable tone.
I didn't even think your tone was that out of line.
Okay.
I think your tone.
Thank
I think,
you.
I think everything you did was fully up. Kosher.
I used to be such an angry person. I'm still pretty angry, but man, I used to. Really let loose.
When you do coke and get angry at all the injustices that white people have done.
Yeah. Well, I wouldn't get angry. I'd get scared. I'd be like, do they know? And then I'd ask my friends and they'd be like, yeah. But then they would say what they thought about white people and I'd lose my fucking mind.
It's like, hey.
Yeah.
Hey.
One time I got my Lebanese friend. I was like bugging him for like hours. I was like, just tell me what your family thinks about white people. Just tell me what they think about white people. And he was like, nah, bro. I was like, nothing. They don't really, nothing. And I was like, yes, they do. Tell me what it is.
They have thoughts.
He was like, okay, fine. They think you guys are dirty. And I was like, pardon me? Totally lost it on him.
Surely that's got to be more annoying than somebody being mildly racist.
Being stinky?
No, no. Being like, come on, bro, forgive me. Please.
That is.
Yeah,
that is way more annoying.
I need you to absolve me. Shit, my great grandparents did. Like,
no, I was saying like that. I was saying like, I just wanted to know the deep and dark dirty.
We're dirty.
Why do they think we were dirty?
But they think we're dirty.
Yeah.
That doesn't seem right.
It's just, I don't know. I don't know what I was expecting to hear. Yeah.
I used to work with this Turkish guy who would wash his penis in the public sink at the work site.
And?
Fair enough if he thought we were dirty because we weren't washing our penises in the gentleman's bathroom sink.
I wouldn't say it's fair, but I can understand why.
Like, I could see why he would think we're dirty if we're not doing that.
Would he fill up the sink and like dip his penis in,
like,
or under the tap?
So I only caught like peripheral glimpses of him doing this.
Mm-mm-mm.
And then I would mostly hear about it because the Italians on the site would... You'd know when they found it because they'd walk in and then you'd go, oh, hey. hey.
What the fuck?
And then every time they saw him on the site, they'd be like, hey, there's cock washer over there. Whoa. Is your cock dirty now, sucker? At the end of the day and stuff. They're crazy.
At least his hands are clean.
It was crazy, like, cultural feuding. It was these, like, Turkish dudes who were washing their dicks in the sink, and then the Italians.
I guess they should. You should be washing your dick.
Is it just every time he pisses, he would fully wash his dick?
I don't know the specifics on, like, it was usually in the morning.
Yeah.
And then the guys, the Italians would be mad basically the whole day.
I mean, can't you do that at home?
That's what I do. I shower.
I wash in my sink at home.
Wash in the kitchen sink.
Wash in the kitchen sink.
I go home
sink,
at lunch.
Dish detergent.
I make some lunch. I wash my penis. I eat my lunch.
I just, I never thought I had a need to wash it more than I do.
I mean, I don't think, I don't know. There's a whole thing like on Twitter about like white people don't wash their legs. And I was like, I've had enough. Because I used to be like very white guilty and like crushed by it. But then I realized I just didn't know enough people that weren't white because it's actually just like a deep frustration with human beings. Like I don't like people.
Yeah.
And the only people I've ever been around are white people. So then I thought like, oh, white people are bad. And then I started meeting other people. I'm like, you guys suck.
Everyone sucks.
You suck so fucking
bad.
But
I guess they all have super clean legs.
That's what the everyone.
Because I feel like if you wash in a shower, you wash your top half. That drips down to your legs.
This is the problem.
The one woman in the room is shaking her head.
We're just gonna take this slowly, bite by bite, because that's what people were saying on Twitter.
Yeah.
And it's like this is a conversation we all need to have.
Are you supposed to wash your legs?
Yeah.
Do they get that dirty?
I feel like gravity does it because the soap and water drips down onto
your legs. You're the reason black people think we're disgusting. I'm not even
water
like,
goes down.
This is the thing is I don't even disagree with you that much. Yeah. I just need everyone to not say that. I need everyone to go, we wash our legs and move on.
Yeah, we wash our legs.
Yeah, thank you. Because that's all Twitter was. It was like, why? Well, it's like being like, what's wrong with not washing the legs? It just drips down. And then black people being like, ugh. And then I was like sitting there like, oh. I wash my fucking.
Wait,
now
do
I
you
wash
guys
my
wash
legs.
Your legs?
I wash them extra now.
Like specifically?
Yes.
If I wash them if I have like shit on them from work.
Yeah.
Then I'll like scrub the shit off. You know? If I have muck or schmutz.
Muck or schmutz?
I'll get the schmutz off.
You get the schmutz off?
Yeah.
On your legs?
Yeah.
I go hair.
Yeah.
Face.
Yes.
Shoulders. Body.
I start top
penis.
Down. Yes.
Asshole. Legs.
Yeah.
Feet. And then I'm done.
You wash your feet? But okay, feet are definitely being
Holy
covered by
shit,
gravity
guys.
In the shower.
I wash my feet.
I hate white people again. I'm back. This isn't white guilt. This is white rage. Like you guys got to be washing all your shit. That's it. Full stop.
I feel like that's probably somehow messing up your skin's biome or something like that.
How is that? Your skin's biome? I think there is an argument for like not washing washing your body every day. I think that there's an argument for that for your skin's health.
Mm-hmm.
But never washing your legs when you are doing a full wash.
it's
insane.
Like but I like clean it's the getting parts covered in water and soap.
Yeah, I know. But you know when you rinse a dish before you put it in the dishwasher and it got most of it, but not all the egg stuff?
But what's the it that you're referring to?
Just general stuff. What do you mean? You ever wash your hands and it's dirty and you're like, whoa, what the hell was that? What have I been touching all day?
But like I'm touching shit with my hands all day. My legs are safely ensconced in my pants. And I wash my pants.
They're not Ziploc bags.
Well, see, I have a Ziploc bag under every sock.
Okay, well then you're. I mean,
but like
your
maybe
shit
I'm
probably stinks
like,
really bad.
It's crazy. Just wet as fuck in
it's
there.
It's crazy. You and homeless people.
You know when you wear a latex glove and then you take it off and your hands are shiny?
Yeah.
That's my whole lower torso.
You just go to bed. You just go right to bed. No, it's because your hair. I mean, your hair catches like dirt, and like guys especially have like dirty legs. So like girls would be like, well, we don't wash our legs, but we shave our legs. So it's like, okay, even that's better than not washing your legs because at least you're shaving the grime off.
I've considered being a shaved leg guy.
Yeah, and
I just don't want to do it. I don't know. I feel like it's like a cool move
to shave your legs.
Yeah,
as a guy,
and like wax them.
Just have like just shiny
really
legs.
Shiny legs.
I think it's like cool.
It's funny.
It is really funny. Because I never wear shorts.
And
but if I
could,
did once.
No one could ever call you on not washing your legs because you
just
pull
just,
them up and
they're like
just
waxed.
Glistening.
Yeah. I just think it'd be
like
funny.
Like a vampire's skin. Just like, I'm Twilight.
Like perfectly tanned.
I'm like
beautiful.
Twilight, but I don't work on my body at all.
I'm Schlubby Twilight.
I'm Peter from Twilight. I'm the hungriest vampire.
Yeah, I'm the high carb vampire.
I'm the Popeye's vampire.
I love two things: chicken breasts and blood.
Invite me into the McDonald's, please.
Yeah.
Say that I can come in.
Putting a line of salt at the entrance to Pizza Hut.
Man,
no.
I tried the chicken McGriddle today.
Whoa. How was that?
And I ate it as I was driving to work.
Was it good?
It was one of those things that like you feel, you get like post-nut clarity from eating it, you know?
Yeah.
It's like,
yeah.
What have I done?
That's
and everything's like moving in slow motion, kind of. Because it's...
Is that just chicken, egg, biscuit?
No, it's like the two pancakes as bread.
Holy
with
shit.
With a junior chicken, piece of chicken in between them.
That's perfect.
Yeah.
Was it good?
It was pretty good.
Start your day
But you
strong.
Also just like feel... Disgusting.
I got the worst food poisoning I've ever had in my life from the chicken McMuffin.
Yeah.
I got to work early on a job once, and I was like, oh, I have time to get like a nice little breakfast. I'll treat myself to a McChicken or the McMuffin with the chicken.
Yeah.
And then like I ate it, and then like as I pulled into the parking lot, I was like, ooh. I felt it immediately. Like I was like, oh, something's up. And then I worked like 3 hours, and all the other guys on my crew were like, dude, you're like green. And I was like, yes, I feel something up. And then on our first break, I went to the bathroom and just like fire hose barfed for like 3 minutes.
Nice.
And then I had to go to my foreman with like tears in my eyes and like a runny nose. And I was like, I have to go home. And he was like, what? I was like, I have to go home. And I like farted. And he was like, okay, go home.
The fart is like, whoa.
He's like, oh, Jesus. Like, get away from me, dude.
Chicken McMuffin.
Yeah, and this is when I was like drinking heavy. So I was like sweaty and like red and like steak. Oh. And it was
just perfect.
It's a nightmare.
You maybe wash your legs after that.
I washed everything. I just like soaked for a while after that.
Yeah. Take a nice big bath, hey?
Yeah, just fucking
just
acid bath.
Out into the bath.
Yeah, just your body. Just
fall asleep in it.
Down the drain. Legs are clean.
Just blasting diarrhea into a bath as you're asleep.
That would suck to like overdose on like fentanyl or some shit, like some Xanax, like some fake Xanax.
And then shit
and
yourself.
Shit. And then just like... Because my girlfriend was talking about someone died recently. I think it was like the lead singer of the Cranberries died recently of an overdose. And like pretty much any time like someone dies where they don't like really say the cause of death or they say that they like overdosed or whatever like that, they're either like puking on their own, like choking on their own vomit because they can't like, but apparently like fentanyl and shit, like what all the fake painkillers are made out of. Apparently, I don't know if this is 100%, I don't know if it's true, but I heard from someone who works in like the medical field that you are aware of what's happening. So
when you're nodding off, you're still like conscious?
You can feel your diaphragm stop.
Whoa.
Yeah. Apparently though, you feel like amazing. Like it feels like really good, but then you would feel yourself like dying.
That's crazy.
Damn.
And then so a lot of like this lady like died in the tub. But she didn't have like a heart attack or anything like that. She would have just taken a painkiller and then just like couldn't get out of the tub.
That's crazy.
And like drowned?
Yeah.
Damn.
Whoa.
She was, like,
wait, was that Sinead O'Connor?
No, I think that was she died of cancer.
Oh, was it cancer?
No. I think so.
Huh.
I think she had cancer.
I didn't know.
She
that.
Went out swinging.
Yeah.
BDS.
Ooh, okay, and on the topic of the death, shout out to Johnny Hardwick who played Dale Gribble. Shout out to him for dying.
Did he die?
He did, yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, just
Dale Gribble.
Today.
Oh.
From King of the Hill.
That sucks.
Yeah.
I don't know who that is.
You never watched King of the Hill?
I'm aware of it, yeah.
Oh,
but
okay.
It's great.
Yeah.
It's really good.
Dale's a great character, but that guy just died. So.
Yeah, damn. That
Shout
sucks.
Out to him for dying.
That's a big loss.
Did you guys ever see that guy who like made a rap album about like the propane guy from King of the Hill? Like as propane guy?
Oh, that sounds familiar.
I like heard one of the songs and I was like, this is so sick.
It's funny to call him Propane Guy.
Propane Guy.
Propane Guy. I've known a few propane guys. Yeah. A couple propane guys.
What is his name? King or Hill?
Hank Hill.
Hank Hill.
Yeah.
Yep.
I just realized you guys seen the show Louie?
Yeah.
His best friend, the chick, Pamela.
Yeah.
That's the voice of Bobby Hill.
Oh yeah. Pamela Adler.
Oh really?
Yeah. Yeah. She's like a wicked voice actress.
Yeah.
Dang.
Yeah.
I thought they were bringing back King of the Hill, but maybe not anymore. It wouldn't be good if they bring it back anyway, but.
Yeah. Well, the new Beavis and Butthead is pretty funny.
I guess so. Yeah.
Yeah. It's pretty funny
stuff. Yeah, it was pretty good.
The movie where they go to space camp is good. Nice. I always feel like out of the loop on this because I like never watched like The Simpsons or like Family Guy or like.
Damn.
Any of that shit.
You really
like,
missed
any
out on
cool
a lot of culture.
I missed out on like a lot of fun.
This whole show started because we wanted to make a show where we remember Family Guy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you and all the listeners should check out our early episodes where we basically just sit around remembering Family Guy bits.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
I'd be around for that. Yeah. That's like what most of my conversations like are when it comes down to like cartoons.
But you don't remember any of them.
No, I just watch people be like, remember that? And then I'm like, yeah. And they're like, and then he said this, and then he said that. And then Apu is like, da-da-da. And they're like, that's my favorite Simpsons episode. I was like, yeah, me too.
So what yeah. did you watch?
Like,
what was the shit you were on?
Trying to remember what I watched like little kids stuff. And then films, I suppose.
Wow.
You skipped straight to film.
Film.
I just, my mom like had like evangelical level like restrictions.
Ah.
But it was just because the voices bothered her.
Oh.
So she didn't like the voices.
Sure.
Because all the cartoons, and then because I never got it, and then I started watching them, and I'm like, yeah, these are kind of fucking grating. Like, like that's Lois, and then
yeah,
like Peter's like, wah, wah, wah. Like it's all very fair. Like yeah. sound stuff.
That's fair.
Which is tough.
What were the films that you watched?
Just like,
I don't know, just
silky
some like whack
voice,
ass shit
crazy
that my parents would pick
German
up,
expressionist stuff.
My mom would like pick stuff like she'd be like, let's watch a Canadian film. And then she'd rent a Canadian film and it'd be brutal.
God damn.
Be fucking brutal. So
it's awful.
They stole like satellite stuff, so I just watched like what was it, X Extreme TV. I killed that when I was like growing up. That was just like BMX. And,
yeah.
Like,
those channels
skateboarders and shit.
Something has to bring those TV, like Spike TV.
Yeah.
Something. I've been saying that since it went off the air.
They just have to, like, should just play, like, old, cool, like, skateboard videos.
Yes.
Like, they should just have a channel that does that. Because that's, like, I was only allowed, like, a tops an hour a day.
Yeah. Like, I had the hour screen time as well.
Yeah.
But I put most of my effort into circumventing that.
Yeah.
And like sneaking onto the computer.
To go
to look at Newgrounds, to play Newgrounds hentai games.
Oh, fuck, Newgrounds was sick, actually.
Going
that
over to my sick. Friend's house after school so we could look at Newgrounds hentai games together.
Man, that's awesome. My parents like really like kept me like, well, I was like, I grew up on an acreage, so then it wasn't like a lot of, so it was just me in a field a lot. Like,
I imagine you on like a, the way I picture you as a child is like a very proper, like British lad.
Yeah.
In like a sort of estate country
is
home.
Is a chubby boy in shorts?
Yeah. Yeah.
Like one
Hello,
of those
Mom.
Little boy like suits, but it has shorts.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
High socks.
I mean, like, it would be weird where, like, I'm trying to remember what I did as a kid. I read a lot. I loved reading, but that was like an escape thing because as soon as I found alcohol, I stopped reading. So, like, after that.
Just the Cat in the Hat until you were 16.
Pretty much. Just fucking tying one on.
Green Eggs and Ham.
Now
and
I'm
then,
in the bag.
Yeah, one sip of booze and you toss your copy of fucking Redwall or
burn
whatever
all my
in
books.
The garbage.
Just reading The Lorax up until you're 16 and then nothing but Kokanee after that.
Yeah. I used to be able to rhyme. I used to rhyme so good. Throwing up in a field.
That happens once you get... I did the same thing. I loved reading and then I started drinking.
Yeah, well, the same thing. It's like, and then adults are like, "Oh, it's a smart kid." It's like, no, they don't know how to deal with their feelings, and they're just hiding in this book.
Yeah,
with like dragons and stuff.
Yeah, this shit's just cool.
Yeah.
Cooler than anything else in my life.
Yeah. And then I'd read stuff that was like not meant for children. And then I'd be scarred. And then I'd tell my parents about it. And then I would have wasn't, the book would be gone.
You're not allowed to read Stephen King anymore?
No, that was upsetting.
There was a book that made the rounds when I was in like grade four called A Child Called It. You ever heard of this?
I've not, no.
It's this like autobiography this kid wrote, or this is like adult now, but he wrote about his like insanely abusive mom. And it would just go in detail about like all the like crazy shit she used to do to him. And every kid in the class read it, and it like reframed the way I looked at adults forever.
Was it like a like school like project book? Or
no, just... it was a book one kid had brought. I don't know how he like found it, but he brought it and was like telling everyone about it. And then the entire class like borrowed his copy and all read it.
Damn.
And it was like crazy. Like his mom would basically make like mustard gas in the bathroom and like lock him in there for a while.
Wow.
And then he'd like pass out and like puke blood or whatever. And then she'd let him out, or she'd like hold his arm like taxi driver style, like over the stove for a little bit. And it like,
so maybe that's what it takes to get kids reading.
Well, when I was like nine, I was like, oh, tortured. Like adults will do that kind of shit. And then it was like dukes up with every adult for the next like 20 years.
Yeah. You have to go to the bathroom? No, what's in there? Why?
Yeah, it was crazy. His mom used to, the book's nuts. It's worth a read.
Is that why you shower with pants on now?
Yeah, I shower in my clothes.
I'm not bending down to wash my legs. Fuck that. Fuck that. No.
Yeah, it's funny. It's like it's still probably one of the craziest books I've ever read.
There was a meth book that went around that like kids would read and then their parents.
Crank?
Yeah, I don't think I ever read that because
is that what the movie's based on?
Yeah, the Jason Statham movie.
No, the one with Brittany Murphy.
Oh,
there's a movie called Crank about cooking meth.
This was
a teenager who just winds up being on meth. Oh, I think. Okay. And then it's her diary of like, and then
she wrote parents, like poems, right?
Yeah. Parents wanted your kids to read it to be like, look how fucked up drugs were.
But it makes it look cool.
It makes it look edgy.
I don't even think it registers. Like, I think.
Well, when you're an Alice in Chains kid, the book is cool.
Yeah.
You're like, oh, nice.
Because like all the anti-drug stuff I went through in school really made drugs look really cool.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, like did they still have Dare when you were in school?
Yeah.
Not really.
Because like they had videos where it'd be like you take a hit of acid and you go into like Looney Tunes cartoon world. And it's like, whoa.
Yeah. So
and they'd
cool.
Be like, but you might never come back. It's like,
don't care.
The hell that I live in
yeah,
right now.
What the fuck? Yeah.
School sucks.
This shit is horrible.
Why are you telling me this at the worst place in the world?
Okay, I can go live with Daffy Duck or I can get yelled at by a 320-pound, 46-year-old librarian. Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to go live with Elmer Fudd, please.
Yeah, I'm pouring my Elmer's glue into a Ziploc bag and huffing that. See if that works.
Dude, I remember there were kids in my... elementary or junior high, they had the Sharpies that had like a smell to them.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Girls used to take the cap off like 12 and hold like a bundle and just sniff them.
Yeah.
And they'd be like, I have a headache.
Girls still do that. Just not with Sharpies.
With lotion.
Just with iced coffees all day. I don't know why I feel like shit right now. It was the last full meal you had. Stop. Stop.
Sorry, you got to get
kid
yourself.
I started smoking in elementary school.
Really,
you did?
Yeah, no, I did. I didn't start, but there was a kid who, when I would be like eight, he started
smoking
cigarettes.
That's awesome.
Yeah, just come out on the playground, and he's off in the corner,
the fat
Italian, in the dark,
standing next to like the playground supervisor, like.
And at the time, I didn't realize how
it's such,
how
so
cool
sick
it
you
was.
Can do an act out with a cigarette.
Yeah. I'm just picturing like this fat like. Like that the kid in that video you sent, like just a hefty kid who carries it standing next to like some lady in a vest, just being like,
he looked like AJ Soprano.
Nice.
He was like a heavyset kid with the AJ Soprano, like double sides
that's
haircut.
So, just ripping darts.
Just ripping darts. At
little, what was his
years
name,
old.
Tommy?
I believe it was John.
John.
I think.
Was he good in school?
No.
No, he's a wicked contractor now, though.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yeah.
I mean, at the time, I was like, why would anyone ever smoke a cigarette?
That guy.
But now I realize what a cool badass he was.
That is really cool.
He's probably doing really good now.
Yeah, that
his
dude.
His mom is probably locking him in the bathroom. You know, just a break.
Giving his kids some mustard gas.
Yeah, holy fuck, but you get cigarettes, so they don't tell you about abusive parents. Yes, you get locked in the bathroom sometimes and beaten over a stove, but.
But here's a pack of smokes.
She passes out and leaves her cigarettes out.
There's a silver lining to everything, guys.
The first time I smoked weed was with a fifth grader.
How old were you?
25.
That's weak, dude. I just started grade 8, and like my buddy's older brother was like 17, and rolled a joint downstairs, and we went over to his house, and then I just watched him do it, and then everyone stood outside, and then like all my buddies were like standing there watching, and this kid. It was like in grade 5. He used to go to apparently his dad had like trash bags full of weed, and then he would just take like an ounce and sell it to the 17-year-old for like $20.
Damn.
And then the 17-year-old would always like give him a hard time, like, I'm not paying you. Like, he was like, you fucking man. Like, he wasn't like a good kid. Like, he was like one of those kids. Yeah. Like, just like ratty fucking. Like,
just a dirt kid.
And then he passed. The older kid passed it to me, and I put my whole like it all in my mouth, and was like,
Ahmed cigarred it.
Yeah, 100%. And then, yeah, when I passed it off to the kid, the 9-year-old looked at me and was like, "It's not a dick. You don't gotta suck it like it is one." And I was ruined in the thing. Like everyone, they all started laughing at me, and this kid just like hit this like fucking Snoop Dogg. and kept passing it, and then holy fuck,
I love kids who are like way too old for their body.
Yeah, that
like an 8-year-old smoking cigs is so fucking funny.
It is really,
or like
funny.
A fifth grader like telling you how to smoke pot.
It ain't a dick, bro.
That is, dude. That is the funniest thing on the planet. Yeah. When like a fifth grader is just like,
it's annoying because it's like that was my chance to be like a cool eighth grader.
Yeah.
Is to smoke weed with a 17-year-old and a fifth grader was like, you're gay.
High for the first time. You just got called gay by a 10-year-old.
Yeah, this kid's smaller than me, and I'm scared of him. I'm scared he'll beat me up.
That used to happen at the skate park all the time. Because my dad was like, in the 90s, like, whack at BMX like crazy.
Really?
Yeah, he was like semi-pro BMX for a while.
Dude, that's sick.
Yeah, metal as fuck. So he used to like take me to the skate park, and like he would stunt on me but I was like, yeah, go dad, like fuck yeah.
Yeah.
But then like when younger kids were just as good as my dad, I'd be like, can we go home? I actually am not having fun anymore. This sucks. Because some like 6-year-old just did a backflip. Like, oh, this sucks.
It's bad for both of us.
Yeah.
I don't know how to ride a bike.
Yeah. I in his head, he's like, I wish that was my son.
That'd be funny if your dad didn't teach you how to ride a bike. Yeah. And then he's just like in a half pipe. Like, just doing like McTwists.
He would just be like, we're going to go for a bike right now. And I'd be like, okay. And then he'd just do like wheelies the whole time.
Dude, my dad would do that, but we had quads, like four-wheelers and shit. And like my dad built me a flamethrower once. Because like, cool. I think him and my mom got an argument over like me.
That's it, I'm making Will a flamethrower.
She would be like, you need to spend more time with your son. And then he would go to the shop for like 3 days and then come out with a weapon. Like, so he built me this flamethrower, and he showed me how to use it. Like turn it on, how to light it, and it was like you didn't need a lighter. It was just like hooked to the propane tank, and then it had a wand on it. Like it was literally a militia flamethrower, like a homemade flamethrower.
Damn.
And he was like, okay, this is how you do it. This is how you use it. And then he was like, all right, I gotta go to work. So, and then he just got in his truck and then left, and then came back and like. A lot of stuff was burnt down. And then my dad was like, did you do that? And I was like, I was not. No. My dad would be like, you tell me, look me in the eyes, and you say, you tell me the truth. And I'd be like, I didn't do that. And he'd be like, I believe you. And I'd be like, my eyebrows were burnt. And like, my dad always rode hard for me. But then he'd also set me up for like, yeah.
I don't know what he expects.
That's crazy.
You give a kid a flamethrower?
All he needs to do is like get me to say, I didn't burn down the neighbor's farm field. Like, I didn't endanger his livestock. And then my dad would be like, all right. Then he would like call the farmer back and be like, you ever fucking accuse my son of doing anything like that again, I'll come over there. And then hang up. It's like, shit, that's sick, dad. There you go. I don't know what he'd do after that.
I had a stepdad who did the opposite. Like when I was like 14, my neighbor asked me to like house it.
Yeah.
And so I would just go over every day and like feed his cats and shit. And I did like I was like mad good at it. Like, I just worked like hard. I like tidied everything, like cleaned up the cat litter, watered all the plants. And then when he got home, he just tried not to pay me. And he was like, my house is a fucking wreck. And then my stepdad was like, did you just not do it? And I was like, no, like I did it every day. And he was like, I don't think he did. And I was like, what the fuck?
Oh my God.
And he called the neighbor back and he was like, sorry, my kid's such a fuck up.
Oh shit, dude.
I was like, what the fuck?
Oh my God.
I was going to get like $200 too because he was gone for a while.
Dude, no wonder you don't wash your legs. I'm sorry. I was
like, dude, I was so pissed. And then I saw that neighbor naked on his front lawn like 3 years later.
Yeah.
I was driving home and he it was like 4 p.m. I don't know why he was naked, but he like left something in his car. So he like had figured like he could just go out and get it. Yeah, and no one would look.
Enough time. My dick's small enough. Yeah. No one's gonna see it that fast.
I like pull into like the cul-de-sac, and immediately he's got his briefcase like over his balls. It's like, the fuck is Dale naked right now? And then he had to do. He like switched it around to his ass as he like shimmied inside. It was like that was enough compensation for him not paying
gotcha.
Me.
Gotcha, gotcha back.
Because you got exposed for
saw
thinking.
Your butt.
Well, for thinking, what's in my head? It's equal because now he knows that I know that he thought it was chill to go out naked at like 4:15 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
to get something from his car in like a. Like a condo neighborhood.
You should have pulled out your phone and taken a picture of him.
Should have pulled up on him. Like drove your car onto his lawn. Like leaned on the horn.
Just hit his car while he's in it.
You trying
naked.
To lure kids into your house?
Pedo.
That would have been a good move. Like while he's in leaning in the car naked, I go up and hit the car so then he kind of shimmies and has to... Falling naked is one of the funniest things on the planet.
That is very funny.
When you fall down and you're nude.
Yeah. Break a hip. So old man.
Have to get an ambulance to come and get you. When you're naked.
This guy's naked. He tried to fuck me and then he fell over. No, I just said no and then he fell.
Do you want us to send somebody? Nah, I just wanted to tell someone.
No, I just need someone to talk to.
Anyway, how are you?
It's like pretty good. I just got that new violent pocket pussy. It's been sucking me off like crazy.
You imagine calling 911 and you just hear like
soccer. And it's like, oh, sorry, you're busy right now.
I'm trapped. I'm trapped in my pocket pussy. Please send help.
Yeah. Are they coming? Nah, he's we don't have Narcan, so he's done. He's done.
He's done. The 911 guy was... Occupado.
He's a little busy, if you know what I mean.
Did you guys hear about that little Tay chick who faked her own death for internet clout?
I did.
I'd never heard of her before.
I didn't.
I had heard of her. As the youngest guy here, I did hear about her.
Are you
her.
The youngest guy here? How old are you?
I'm like 45.
You look great.
I'm well preserved, but yeah. Nice. He's in my mid-40s.
Mid-40s.
Bald.
He's nice. Jacked, though.
Keep
you know,
going.
Holding it together, though.
You're very smooth. You're waxed all over.
Bald. 45.
Polished.
Wearing, like, a Tour de France suit.
Very clean legs, despite what you might think from earlier
on. You go
my
so
legs
fast
are
on
actually
that bicycle.
Really clean, just
naturally. The wind just scoops all the schmutz off.
It's like walk so fast.
And the fans, they lick your legs until they're spick and span.
But I feel like there's a lot of people like that who, at least for me, I never hear of them until they die.
Yeah.
So I feel like that could be a way we could promote the podcast.
Maybe we need to die.
If we need to, well, or like sort of Huckleberry Finn it, you know?
I think maybe if you guys had like a feud.
Amongst ourselves?
Between each other or with somebody more popular than us?
No, I think with each other. And then if you shot each other or something like that. And
ooh.
Then press charges and then didn't press charges.
Yeah. You want to shoot me in the leg?
With a potato gun or something.
Just non-fatally shoot each
other? Yeah, something you're allowed to have.
Crossbow my leg.
Yeah.
Because the police can charge you without the other person charging you, but you have to figure out like what's not illegal that someone could charge you for.
But also something that's like human interest story enough, it's going to make the news.
Yeah,
like,
you know,
two podcasters simultaneously shoot themselves with crossbows in a feud.
I feel like that's going to generate something.
So if that doesn't, I don't know what will.
That's a snowball.
If I learned that Joe Rogan, he should kill someone while bow hunting.
That would be so funny.
Joe Rogan accidentally kills Lex Friedman while bow hunting.
And then he has to shut down his podcast because he's not a good bow hunter.
Yeah, he loses all his cred.
And that's why everybody tunes in.
Yeah.
Because it's like, damn, a guy who's that good at bow hunting is also this smart.
Holy shit.
Whoa. They don't make guys like that.
Him and the Liver King. Frauds.
Yeah, that was another guy I'd never heard of till Scandal caught up with him.
I saw Liver King running around, but like I got a buddy who's like eats like organ tissue and
is
shit.
Is he a
like
raw
that.
Meat guy?
He's a raw, no, he's not a raw meat guy, but he's like, he's an egg guy. Like he only eats eggs and like,
eggs and like raw
he'll eat
milk
like
and stuff.
Seven eggs. And cool. He's awesome. And I like, I love him. His views on the world are fucked up. And like he eats a lot of eggs. But
I mean, I like eggs.
That's such a sick way to talk. To like introduce a guy.
Dude, if I wish I could introduce him.
This guy
like
eats
that.
A lot of eggs.
This guy, like, his views on the world are crazy, but he eats so many eggs.
His comedy credits are insane.
Oh, yeah.
He has insane stand-up. He has like the best credits that anyone could get in Canada and probably, you know, good ones for the States too. But then just to be like, this guy eats at least a dozen eggs a day.
That's crazy.
And eats organ tissue and stuff like that. And then so we had a conversation about that once, and then Liver King started popping up. I was like, yeah, right. It was like, I'm not willing to do that for that.
Yeah.
I'm not willing to look.
Liver King ate raw liver, right? Am I mistaken in that?
Yeah, I think he was big on like raw shit.
Was he raw? Because
like, I see people online eating raw meat now.
Yeah.
And it's kind of like, was I just lied to my whole life that raw meat is like dangerous?
No.
Because like, I'll prepare raw meat and just like, if I'm touching it, it's like I touch it, then I go like wash my hands, then I like, you know, season the other side and like wash my hands and shit like that.
That's crazy. You don't wash your legs, but you do all this shit.
Well, when I touch raw meat, because it was drilled into me that it's dangerous. But yeah. I'll see some guy on the internet eating like 5 pounds of raw ground beef.
Yeah, I think what you're doing is the right thing to do, and you should keep doing that, and don't let these people sway you into eating.
Don't seem to be getting sick though.
They're turning the camera off,
throwing up,
and like they have like a hospital. Because there was one guy who was like online who was like, "I'm gonna eat raw meat every single day until I die," and then it's just like 500 days, and then people are like, "Are they lying to us?" And it's like, no, they're not lying to you, but. Just because you eat raw meat doesn't mean you're immediately going to get something bad. Like, apparently human stomachs are like scavenger stomachs. So this is like the same as a seagull. Yeah. So like shit will like, it'll just like, you'll destroy anything.
So you're saying you can eat raw meat.
You can.
And it's fine and good for you.
It's not fine.
So what I'm hearing is that it's all good.
It's not all good.
Because I've seen seagulls eat like poo and they're fine. So.
Yeah. They look fine. They're living good lives.
I mean, dogs
eat
raw meat. I don't see, it doesn't seem fair that they can do it and I can't.
You can, actually.
Yeah.
I think you can.
Yeah.
I mean, guys on TikTok are doing it every freaking day.
Yeah, let them. Yeah. Let them see what happens.
That is my attitude towards basically everything online is like, I have no desire to interview. Like, I see people like.
Yeah. Yeah, like, commenting. Or
trying to be like, don't do that. And it's like, what are you guys doing?
Shh.
Shut the fuck up. Let him.
He's going to do it.
Yeah, let him go, man. Yeah. What are you doing?
A kid did that on when I was like in elementary. There was like this like 12 stairs beside our school. And he was like on his bicycle and I didn't like him. And everybody was trying to get him to not bike down the stairs. And I was stopping everybody from stopping him. I was like, let him do it. It was the one time I was ever nice to him. I was like, you got this for sure, dude. And he did actually make it down the stairs. And I was like, fuck.
Nice. I was going to say that's high risk, high reward. Because you silence everybody and you're like, he's got it. And he biffs it. Big dub for you.
Yeah.
If you silence everyone. And then he nails it.
That's also a big W.
Yeah, I think that's a win-win.
It is
a
win-win.
Either way.
I mean, I was disappointed, but then I had to pretend and be like, woo, yeah, guys. Yeah.
That's what I mean, though. It's like,
come on, guys.
It's a win-win socially for the whole group, but like for you,
yes.
Be like, oh, now he looks cooler because he nailed the trick, too.
And it's like, okay, well, now we got to find a bigger set of stairs. 15 years later, I'm his manager.
Yeah, he's jumping over through flaming hoops and stuff.
Yeah. I'm like, put another one up there. You can do it. Yeah.
I want to start a construction site that's all dirt bikes.
Like people dirt biking between stations
and
stuff?
Yeah, like if you need to move lumber. It's just dirt bike construction.
That'd be so cool.
Just have ramps and jumps everywhere.
No, not a single truck or van to haul anything. It's all we like hook up more dirt bikes if we need it. You get like nine guys pulling a trailer.
Like two guys on either side of a big sheet of drywall. And
Yeah.
Trying to estimate out. It's like, man, it'll take probably like 3-4 months. It's like this small landscaping job. It's like, buddy,
We only work with dirt bikes. We're artisanal landscape.
You know who you hire.
Shredding the lawn on your dirt bike.
Burnout marks everywhere.
All right, we got to get rid of the sod. It's just eight dirt bikes just spinning their tires. Yeah. Yeah,
I think that'd be dirt bike construction would be so cool.
Drunk dirt bike construction.
Like, you know, like building like high rises downtown, all dirt bikes.
On the 34th.
Yeah, you
floor.
Just hear the no windows, yeah. No railing.
Washing windows with dirt bikes.
They're just like around. Yeah, you install like a track around and they can just.
It actually might work because if you clean up here and then you just go like this down, then the dirt from your tire is always. It could work. You could do this.
I would. You guys want to go. Be partners in dirt bike construction.
That'd be so scary. You're working in an office building. It's just a dirt bike. It's like, oh, Tom Cruise is filming a new thing.
And I'd branch it off into different businesses, like dirt bike hauling. You know, if you need something taken across the country,
right?
We hook up like 15 guys on dirt bikes.
Yeah, these guys
cool
all from small towns.
Getting like Uber Eats. If there was an Uber Eats, but you knew for sure your driver was going to be like a cool stuntman dirt bike driver.
Yeah. Like hops the curb, rides right up to your front door.
Yeah.
Doesn't turn the engine off.
Back one star for the food being all fucked up.
Yeah, he doesn't. He's tucked it under his arm. He squished it all.
What kind of center of gravity do you have?
We give him all.
You know he's here because you hear the loud revving on your front steps.
You just hear car horns as he weaves through traffic and as he's jumping cars. And
you just hear an ambulance come. You're like, oh, food must be about a block away.
Splattered all over the sidewalk.
Yeah, like, wouldn't that be sick? You order a pizza and then you just like a fucking dirt bike crashes through the front of your house.
It's a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle on it.
Would it be better
a 17-year-old boy on there?
Just
dead. I got your pizza. His neck is sticking out crazy.
Like, would it be better for the environment if everybody just dirt biked everywhere instead of driving cars? Probably.
In my mind, that sounds about right.
Yeah.
I mean, a car
maybe.
Is bigger.
Sound pollution,
if
though.
If everyone's just blasting around on dirt bikes all
but
the time.
But we all, you know, it's like, yeah, you don't always see your nose. You're not always noticing your nose.
Yeah.
If there was just a constant hum of dirt bikes.
But it could all be like, you know, like the beginning of motocross events where there's like the giant cluster. That could just be like the rules for all of the road. Like no more lanes, no more speed limits. Just like,
you mean
winner
India.
Takes all.
Yeah, that is
you're describing India with shitty dirt bikes.
For the environment, you know?
Well, India is just that, but they put the body of a car on a dirt bike most of the time.
It's a truck bike.
Yeah, it has like a cabin.
Yeah, they load it. They load the passenger side up, and then they get their fattest friends to sit on the left side.
They just put like a truck bed on the back of a dirt bike with like wheels.
Yeah,
and
their
rules.
Cars are nuts.
So you got to drive it real fast so it doesn't tip over.
Indian cars are so crazy.
That is wild.
Yeah, like just like the traffic footage is nuts, but if you just pause and like look at the actual vehicles that are in there,
yeah,
it is. It'll be like a Vespa scooter that has like a semi truck. Cabin like welded to it, and then it has like an extra wheel that they like jammed in, and then it so it doesn't tip really, but it still kind of tips.
That's pretty good.
It's so sick.
That's gonna be good.
I can't see what like that lifestyle, like just every day I'd get up for work being like, oh, I get to take the dirt bike semi truck.
I mean, that is like what white trash. That's white trash.
That is small town everywhere.
Yeah
100%. What are we gonna take to work today? My car or the quad?
Or my homemade freaking van bike.
Yeah, my van bike.
Yeah, government can't track it. Too fast.
No license
Way
plate.
Way too fucking fast.
I just got into this guy on YouTube who, as a hobby, he drives a Porsche GT4 with no license plate in New York City.
Okay.
And so his like hobby is he drives like around until a cop sees him.
Yeah.
And turns the lights on because he doesn't have a license plate.
Yeah.
And then his hobby is just
doing GTA
like
escapes.
Leading the cops around for a little bit and then hitting the highway and just leaving them.
He does it in a car, hey?
Yeah.
I've seen people on bikes do that.
This guy's nuts.
But doing it in a
He's
car is wild.
Crazy. Like narrow New York roads with like both sides full of parked cars. And he's like weaving into the oncoming and like passing people. And the cops just are like done.
That's
so
cool.
Crazy.
I
so
love
cool.
police chase.
They're like
footage.
The police have a problem with shooting people. It's like, I wonder.
Well, that's white guys. He's a white dude.
Yeah,
because he's like, as a hobby, I'm gonna dick with the cops. I've never seen his face because it's just dash cam footage.
Yeah,
but I just know it's a white dude.
It is pretty sick. I guess you get arrested and it's like, oh, what was I going too fast?
He never gets caught, ever.
And he's eating raw meat. Yeah. He's just eating raw meat.
I'm surprised they don't tag him with the helicopter.
I don't know, man.
It's like I've watched a lot of the police chase footage.
Yeah.
And usually it's like they kind of like stay back a bit.
Yeah.
But like once the helicopter's on you, like you, I guess you can wait it out because at some point it has to land.
Yeah. But
usually once the helicopter's
well,
on
the
you,
the helicopter's
tough to
just
like,
they're like, okay, he's going this way. So then just block off this and this.
Yeah.
And just like, what alert? I feel like the helicopter would get, a helicopter got me once.
What?
Really?
Yeah. I was like 16 or 17. I went to the bar with my sister with like a fake ID. And I got like plastered, and then my sister was at the bar, and she was like, "We're all leaving now." And I was like, "Okay." So yeah. I walked outside, and no one was outside, and I was like, "I didn't know we're leaving now means like we're leaving, we're getting everyone to go."
Yeah.
So I was just like, "They fucking left me," and so I walked from Knoxville's on Jasper Ave to the Yellowhead, and then I started walking down the Yellowhead trying to flag down cabs. To get a ride
on
back
the Yellowhead.
To, on the Yellowhead.
Which, to, for our listeners, is not really an appropriate place to.
That is
a
highway.
Yeah. It is literally a. Yeah, it's a freeway.
That is a freeway that goes and through the entire city.
Like 10 and a half kilometers from. No, maybe not that, but like probably like 7 kilometers from Jasper Ave. So then I like. I also remembered like I was like kind of blacking in and out. And I remember I was like near Plains. I was like beside Plains. And I was, and this guy was like, what the fuck are you doing here? And I was like, and I ran away from the Plains. Because I was trying to find the Yellowhead. But I was like, I was just like, and I, my phone, I like, I texted my sister too because she was calling me. And I was like, I went home with a girl. Like I was so, dude, I was insane. I was so,
that's crazy.
I was like evil, just evil mode. You know what I mean? Like just evil.
You were purple grinning devil horn emoji guy.
Exactly. And I was like, I feel like I can walk back to Sherwood Park where my car was.
Holy shit.
Because I lived outside of Sherwood Park. And then I drove to this girl's house who's older, who I knew, whose older sister, it was her birthday. And then, or maybe it was her birthday. I don't know how it worked out, but it was someone's birthday. We went on a party bus and I had a fake ID. Anyway, so I walked to the Yellowhead and I obviously went through the old airport and got chased out of the old airport, made it to the Yellowhead. And then I would flag cabs down and I'd be like, how much to get back there? And they'd be like, $100. And I'd slam the door. I'd be like, suck my fucking dick. And then like kick their car. And then finally, like the third or fourth cab that stopped was like $60. And I was like, done. I was like, good man. And then I got in and I was like, you're a real good guy. And like, whoop, whoop. And then like immediately gets pulled over. And I was like, what the fuck did you do? Like, I was like, who are you? And I was like yelling at him. And then I just got hauled out of the cab. And then they put me in the back of the cop car and then like pulled off somewhere. And then they like put me in cuffs and like put me against the car. And then like, or no. Because I must have looked young. So they, because they didn't put me in cuffs yet, but they, I gave them my real ID. I gave them my, like, my I'm, like, 16 ID or whatever.
Yeah.
And then, because they were arresting, I can't remember, they were, like, arresting me or something was going on. Clearly, something was going on. And then they saw my address, which is, like, in Ardrossan, and they were like, you're a long ways from home. And I was like, fuck you. And they were like, okay, buddy. They were like, do you want to ride home? And I was like, whatever. And then these two cops were like, where were you? I was like, I was at a party with my friends. I was at a party.
I was smoking weed with a fifth grader.
Where was it?
Yeah. Idiot.
You guys just wait till Randall shows up. You guys think you're fucking cool with your guns? This little fifth grader's gonna pull a gun on you. Shoot you in the face. Smoking a blunt. And then, yeah, like I told them I was at a party. And then they drove me so far home. Like it's like a 45-minute drive from the city.
God damn.
Out to the country.
Were you guys making like small talk?
No. They would ask me questions and I would just like, I'd be like, whatever. I'd be like, yeah, whatever. I like threw a lip in and I was like, but I was too dry mouth for like, it was tired. So I was like, and I was like, oh, like it made me feel fucked up. And then they, and then I got out of the car because at my parents' place. And then I like slam the back door and then the cop like opens the back door and he's like, do you want to take your chewing tobacco out of my car? And I was like, and I went back to the car and I grabbed the chewing tobacco and I like threw it as hard as I could. I was like, oh. And then I walked into the house and they were, or they like stopped me from going in the house and they like knock, they were like, you got to knock on the door. and to make sure. And I was like, this is my house. And they're like, okay, well, we have to talk to your parents. I was like, well, they're not awake, so I'll go get them. And I walked in their house and I was like, the police are here. And my mom was like, what? And I was like, I'm going to bed. And then I just went to bed, and then I woke up the next morning and I was grounded for a year. Like, so grounded, because I know this whole story like makes me sound like I just showed up to like a castle on acreage, like just a big place, but it wasn't that. And my parents were not lenient people by any stretch fucking at all.
And you just went on a like GTA like 5-star tear through town. Like,
on legs. It was on legs.
On legs.
On leg. And then yeah, man. And then, yeah, I was grounded for eternity. And anytime I would get a window of opportunity to hang out with my friends, even for like 2.5 hours, I'd like come home and they'd be like, are you drunk? And I'd be like, no. And then it was like, I'd be wearing like a trapper's hat, like it was like old fucking flappy hats.
I love those.
Yeah, they're awesome.
I have like 3.
I'd come home drunk and I'd be like, I should put on this hat. Then they won't know. This
will distract them. Yeah. How drunk I am.
And then I immediate grounding again. Like,
coming
just
home with
double
a propeller
ground
hat. Are you drunk? And you're like,
psh. Yeah. I'd be like, no.
Would a drunk guy be wearing this hat?
Can't smell this hat. This hat doesn't smell like alcohol. And then yeah. So then yeah. Then I'd be back into prison immediately.
That's so funny.
And then my dad would like be like, you gotta get outside. You gotta spend more time outside with this flamethrower.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, you're misbehaving? I'm gonna go build you a gun.
Yeah, straight. Or just give me a gun. Like, we had guns. We had like a ton of fucking guns.
That is masterclass parenting.
It was nuts. For my mom. I think it was hard for my mom because she was like, eventually, she was like, at first, she was like, oh yeah, my dad, like, my husband knows what he's talking about. He knows how to like punish a young man. And then, because I'd also, they'd like make me work, like if I'd come home drunk, and then like, this only happened like 4 times, but they were always really bad.
Yeah.
Like one time I like, within the first week of getting my license, I hit like 4 cars in one night.
And then, were you drunk driving?
No, sober. Oh, okay. And, yeah, I was drunk.
Okay.
Yeah,
I was just a terrible driver.
I was fucked up. And then I came home, put the hat on, and then they saw the hat and they were like, again? And then, they'd like work, and then I'd just work, and then they would just like work me, so I'd like have to like clean up a bunch of shit out of the yard or like just work all day like hungover. And then every day was just like I'd go out to the shop and like work, and I don't know, I just wind up working. The punishment was work.
Yeah, I had a stepdad like that. It was just like, just do labor.
Yeah. Hard, because that's how I'm going to raise my kids.
I'm going to build them weapons.
Build them weapons. Yeah. I mean, handling explosives will teach them responsibility
real
fast.
That is expert parenting. Like, if your wife is like, you just spend more time with the boy, being like, okay. And then I just picture like the shop on your property is like all the doors are closed and there's just like light coming out of the bottom.
Yeah.
Out of like the bottoms of doors, and it's like, all night. And then he comes out with like a railway spike rifle. And he's like, here you go.
Well, we had a potato gun. And we'd shoot, and then that exploded once out the back. And for probably 3 years, I didn't have eyebrows.
The potato gun incident?
Potato gun and just other fires.
You were a fire guy?
Just, I wasn't a fire guy, but fire would come at me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I didn't like love fire.
Right.
Fire's pretty cool. I liked what fire could
Nothing
do.
Nothing against fire.
No, fire is cool.
Yeah.
Fire is cool.
That's so funny.
Me and my friends started a little mini forest fire by Kinsman.
You told me that nice. About that a couple years ago.
Like when they had all the fluff on the ground, you know, spring, I guess that is. And we were lighting it on fire, and it would go in like a little, like a firewall kind of, and then burn out. It was really cool. Then we started one, and it just went out in a circle and didn't stop.
You just go home and take a shower?
Yeah, we quickly walked away, and as we were on the path, some guy passed us. He was like, did you guys start that fire? And my friend was like, no, we saw some black guy running away.
It sucks because you don't want to get caught for arson, but you're like, yeah.
That's
literally how it starts.
That's a quiet
the cops are
home.
Like, at your house, they're like, what do you look like? And you're like, oh, fuck, my friend describe him? Yeah. Oh, shit.
That's a quiet walk home, too. After that, like, the guy leaves, and you're just like,
Yeah, we were just
we
all
should leave.
Sitting in my buddy's car, driving away, looking at the smoke.
Holy shit, you guys had licenses?
Yeah. I was probably 18. I'm pretty sure I was out of high school.
Bro.
Oh. You were voters.
Holy shit.
Yeah, I could vote.
Oh my God. Yeah. That's so past the point of like, it's like maybe we did something bad.
No, like, that's really bad what we did. Like jail bad.
I'm pretty sure the statute of limitations has passed now, though, so it's fine for me to talk.
Well, you're
about.
You're like 51 now,
yeah,
so
was
yeah,
20, 30 years ago.
That was in the, yeah, the 70s.
Back in the day.
Back yeah. in the day. I don't even
fire?
Think that was illegal back
fire
then.
Fire was like Wi-Fi. It was everywhere.
Yeah. I mean, it wasn't like in these woke times where no. people are against that kind of stuff.
Yeah,
it was
this
cool.
This was in 78.
Yeah.
Back when everything was chill.
No one put out fires with their pussy juice.
Well, that was before women were allowed to get wet.
Yeah.
In 78, they hadn't invented wet pussies yet.
No, they didn't.
Yeah.
No, they just invented...
One guy lit a dumpster on fire and soaking wet pussies everywhere. Yeah. That's why you do it.
Fire is the ultimate key to a woman's heart.
Fire.
Like building a fire.
Yeah.
If you can start a fireplace or like have a fire pit that you can like consistently get going.
I should get a fire pit down here.
That's also when you realize you don't need a woman. Is once you've lit a fire and then she's like gone, you're like... This is fine.
I can just look at the fire.
Yeah. Dude, it totally, that's the one time I like tap into like biological heritage is when I'm near fire.
Mm.
And it's like, oh no, this is the shit.
Water's like that too.
Yeah.
You get near a river.
And it's woo! Like, oh, what else do I need?
Nothing.
Nothing.
You don't need
fire,
anything.
You got water.
I can just sit
ground
here.
Beef. Yeah. Raw.
I don't need a I don't need a podcast or anything. I can just sit here.
Yeah.
My government-induced autism is gone.
Yeah.
And you're finally free again.
Yeah, you can just sit near a fire.
Free
or
to look at the fire.
Stare at it. Yeah. It puts you in like a fugue state.
What?
A fugue state.
What does that mean?
It's
like kind of like when you're looking at a fire. You know that feeling you get?
It means you're not legally responsible for your actions.
Actually, that's fair. My buddy, like, we had this place that we'd start fires, like have bonfires and shit, and like drink out when we were like 13 and 14, and like he got so mad because he showed up and he was hammered, and he's like, who the fuck put barbed wire in the fire? And then he grabbed it and pulled it out and was like, ah!
When I remember grade 4, one of my buddies showed up with bandages on his hand.
Yeah.
From like, it was like a Monday, and his mom was walking him into the class that day. And we were like, yo, Jared, like, what's up with your hands? And his mom interrupted him. He was going to be like, and his mom was like, this dumbass fell in the fire.
That's so good.
And like, she walked him in to just like embarrass him in front of, and then she was like, all right, Jared, have a good day. And his mom was like a big, like battle axe type lady.
That's.
And she left and he was like, I fell in the fire. Sorry.
Yeah, I fell.
Okay.
Sounds like you fell, Jared.
Yeah, she definitely.
Like no one else was involved in this.
Oh yeah,
big shoulders.
His mom was
woman.
Shooting flaming arrows at him on the weekend, and she was like, "Catch him!"
Ah, you're not even trying to catch him. I know. I try. Just try.
It's like either this or the mustard gas bathroom again, Jared.
Someone gotta go tinkle.
Yeah, it's crazy. I haven't thought about the mustard gas bathroom in a long time.
That is a pretty fucked up thing.
Can you imagine like being the husband? Like, honey, is the bathroom free? And she's like, no, there's mustard gas in there. Like,
did you at least turn the fan on? Jesus Christ.
No, I'm gassing the sun in
like,
there
I
again.
I get you want to gas the kid, but I use that bathroom too.
You really have to use the ensuite for this?
It's just like, whoa. Kid's almost dead.
Yeah, light a candle or something, huh?
Yeah. She's like, don't light a candle. Do not light a fucking candle.
Yeah, that was a big thing in the book was the dad just kept being like, sorry, champ.
Dude, that would be hard. I love my girlfriend so much. And she got so mad at me once because she was like, we were watching a movie and it was like about a guy who had a second family.
Oh,
and
damn.
She was like, please don't ever do that to me. Please don't ever like get a second family and like have a different family in a different town and like don't make your children like live through that. And I was like, deal. I won't do that. Don't drown our kids in a tub. And then she lost it. And
that
I was
seems
like
a fair trade.
That's very
I feel
fair.
Archetype, tub, town. Tub, different town, you know? Like,
yeah.
That felt like fair. But they, so I'm, she's like not crazy, but I've seen like her, like it come out sometimes. It's not that I, like I'm crazy too. Like I walked down the Yellowhead, but like I've seen her crazy come out sometimes. And I'm like, I don't know who I would pick in that. I don't know if I would have like, you know what I mean? You go to work all day and the kid comes back and the kid's like kind of fucked up and you're just like, what's up, sweetheart? You just give her a kiss. What's for dinner? Nice. And then
oh,
you just,
not, yeah.
You're like, you got things pretty good here. And the kids just won't look at you in the eyes. You're like, it's probably fine.
I'll maybe make him a flamethrower.
Yeah.
Boost his spirits a bit.
You got to fight your way out of this.
I don't know how guys do the double family thing.
That is a
like you hear, but just like, how do you make that work?
That is nuts.
Like, you have to have a job as a traveling salesman or something. Like,
apparently truck drivers.
Oh, okay. Damn.
I mean, you just drop off dick.
Hey, your dad was a truck driver. That's cool.
But I feel like you have to have some job where you're out of town like a lot. Or else I just don't get how it's feasible.
Or you could do that sitcom thing where you have two dates on the same night.
In the same restaurant?
Coming into the same, like driving from one family dinner to the other and like changing your tie.
Ugh. I feel like that's what girls think of.
Yeah.
Girls are like, oh, he has another family that he loves just as much as this family. It's like, no, this guy's disrespecting you and her.
Yeah.
And everybody there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, you thought he like didn't try that hard for you.
Yeah. Wait till you see his second and third.
Wait till you see who's coming in second place.
Oh my God!
But I feel like I've heard of cases where that happens. Then, like when the guy dies, that's when they find out.
Yeah,
like
they both show up to the funeral.
Both go to the funeral.
Yeah.
Which
I mean, I guess that would be like, I don't know, man.
That's a crazy move.
It's crazy and it is wrong, but it's also like
it's kind of impressive, also
a little bit
to some extent.
That's because it's so
like, that's
bold.
What you're up to? It's like when you find out someone's like built a bunch of trains in their basement, you're like, really?
It's like when you go to someone's house and they're like, yeah, I built this. You're like, what the fuck?
You're like, whoa.
It's a lot of effort.
Wow. And I just look at it for a bit and go, okay.
Nice.
Cool.
It's cool.
You just look at two families at a funeral and be like, wow. Your uncle was weird.
Yeah. It's like when you go to someone's house and he's like, yeah, all built with dirt bikes. And you're like, whoa. Really?
Really? You're trying to get this dirt bike thing started.
I'm really into it, man. I think it's cool.
That would be cool.
You should start wearing dirt biking gear. Get like some like Fox jerseys and stuff.
Well, that's how they put imagine putting in flooring. Like, you know how it like click clacks in?
Yeah.
So a guy lines it up behind the back wheel of a dirt bike and a guy revs it and he goes, shoots it in. You know what I mean?
That would be pretty sick.
So it's instead of all tools too, it's just dirt bikes.
As much as we can, we use the dirt bikes.
Just driving
a dirt
bike.
It catches on a piece of flooring and you shoot through the wall.
You put like drill attachments onto the like axle of the dirt bike.
So you, and then it,
and then you just line it up where you need a hole, and then just you know, and then you have a drill and a flooring device.
Yeah,
and you could just like get a bunch of torque on a hammer, drive real fast by. Just
yeah, that's how you put a hammer in. It's like if I had to nail that wall.
A nail gun. You could have a nail gun while you're driving around on a dirt bike.
Yeah.
Just firing it where you need the nails.
I just think the most reckless construction site possible is extremely funny.
It is funny, but I mean, that's also just construction sites.
Yeah, because every time I'm on one and I'm like, this is crazy. I'm like, it would be even crazier if they all had dirt bikes right now.
Yeah. Dirt bikes and they're smoking crack in the outhouse?
Yeah, and they're peeing on each other.
Yeah, that's fucked up. I used to work with my cousin. And he would shit everywhere. Shit. And one time I shit my pants before work because I was like, just starting kind of stand up and like working all day and then like out at night and then like 5 hours of sleep every night for like 8 months. Then one day I just shit my pants. We like loaded the trailer up and I was like, oh my God. And I went to the washroom and I was like, oh man, I shit my pants. And I was like, I called him and I was like, dude, I shit my pants. And he was like, well, you're working without underwear today. And I was like, I don't think I can do that. And then he got upset with me and I went and changed my underwear and then I met him at the job site. But he was like, he would shit it. And I love him. He's my godfather. I love him very much and he's a good man. So I just want to say that. But he would shit in every unfinished basement. There's probably like 300 to 500 homes right now that have families living in them. And then underneath their cement floor in their basement is my cousin's shit.
Yeah. We were talking about this like a week ago.
Yeah.
I think every house is full of the person who built its shit and piss.
100%.
Yeah. Even like me now, like new houses that are basically done. When I go in there, new houses have been broken in nicely by me and like a couple Portuguese guys vaping in there.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like it's some like lovely family's about to move in, and like me and a weed addicted 31-year-old we're getting like really mad at the shower door 2 days before you and your family have the most like beautiful day of your life.
Oh my god, our new home.
It's so nice. So this is your room? And I was in there 48 hours ago like punching the fucking frame of the door.
It's like one of the kids is like, it smells weird in here. The dad grabs him and is like, we don't use this room.
There's piss bottles in the drywall everywhere.
Oh yeah. Everywhere. Oh my god, the piss bottles. Yeah. One time I my cousin was like, he couldn't find anywhere to shit, and then he went into the ravine. And I was like, where did you go? He was like, I just held onto a tree.
What?
I've heard of guys doing it when they don't have like the grass in on the lawn. They'll just bury it.
Yeah, that's what he would do.
Like
he would like
a freaking cat.
Yeah, like yeah. If there's just all the like loose dirt, you just shit
there. The before the top grade goes in.
Yeah.
Then like before like he would like shit and then like cover it up. And one time I was doing it, I was like holding it, and I was like, there's no bathroom on site. I was like, I gotta, and he was like, well, just go for like 2 hours. He's like, dude, just fucking go.
Yeah.
And the second I went there, the foreman showed up. And he was like, literally, I was like shitting and I was like looking at him through the tinted like basement windows. Yeah. My cousin was like, oh no, and the foreman like went to get the car, and my cousin was like, no, let me show you the deck over here.
I mean, he's seen it all before.
Yeah.
Yeah, he'd probably just make fun of my penis. And
that foreman was the kid, the 8-year-old who was smoking darts.
Yeah.
He doesn't give a shit.
That guy's probably a foreman now.
Yo, dude, whatever company he's with, he's at the top. He's so good.
Yeah.
He's so fat, and he doesn't leave the truck anymore, and he smokes cigs and just eats Arby's in there.
Arby's and darts?
Yeah, Arby's and cigs. And he just looks at blueprints all day. And will occasionally come in and like measure something. Yeah.
And then he goes, no. No.
Nah, it's a little out, but it'll
be fine.
It's fine. Yeah,
good enough.
I had the funniest I was in this house, and like the like site manager came in, and he had the most aggressive like baseball butt I've ever seen in my life. And he had these like tight like work shorts on, and nice. Then like a golf shirt. And his name, he looked like like
dumper.
Just the biggest ass I've ever seen. he came in and just started measuring shit with his big baseball butt. I was like, why do you look like this, dude? Like, of all the like ways you could look, why is this the one you chose? It's like short shorts and a big fucking jacked ass.
Why not? If you got a big jacked ass, you're not trying to hide that thing. He's not allowed to wear a dress.
It was great. And like everyone noticed, like after you left, like all the guys I was working with were like, what the fuck?
That
guy's ass so big?
That ass is huge.
So like the rest of his body was disproportionately big?
He was like relatively jacked, but his ass was just like shockingly large for a guy like that.
What do you think he did?
You have to like be squatting and like working on it.
Jumping.
He's jumping rope.
Maybe he plays some weird sport or something.
He's got to be a baseball guy or hockey.
Maybe hockey.
Yeah. He's got that hockey ass.
Big fat ass.
He was like, and he wore like really tight shorts too.
We wanted to show it off.
Like, you just put like basketball shorts on and like chill.
Nah.
You could put basketball shorts on like the rest of us.
Nah, that would feel good to have like a huge ass. No, everyone's looking at it. Everyone's scared of it.
It's
like, scary. Every time you like look at it, you can tell someone's looking at it, and then you just flex your ass a little bit. And you're like, oh shit. And you turn away.
His job site poops are probably nuts.
Well, do you poop bigger the bigger your ass is?
Yeah.
Is that how that works? That would make sense.
I think so.
I mean, he could probably do whatever he wanted with it. Growing up, my dad used to fart every morning and wake the house up. and he would fart like this. He could control his farts, where he'd be like,
like a dirt bike.
Yeah, like, like he would always come up at the end, and he would laugh so fucking hard, and he would have 3 tuba farts in the morning, and everyone would be like, okay, fine, and then we'd all get up.
And then he'd go build a bomb in the shop.
Yeah, and then he'd be like, this is for you, son.
It's
and
a grenade.
Yeah.
Start loading fertilizer in the back of the panel van.
Yeah. Your dad is Oppenheimer.
My dad could have made it as a white nationalist. Like, really could have made it as a white nationalist, but he's...
But he chose not to?
Well, he was probably just trying to train me.
Your dad was building the biggest sniper rifle ever.
Shot potatoes out of it.
It's like 40 yards long.
What else did he build? I think it was just the flamethrower. We got chickens once. And because I was like begging, I really wanted chickens because there was like a little barn on the house. And I think they used to grow weed there. And because they had all these strings and stuff. So my dad was like, okay, that'll be a good project. Because like my dad always wanted us to be farm kids, but I was like a pussy and like liked books. And and then so he was always trying to get me to do farm shit. So then we got chickens from this family friend that had like a huge farm with a bunch of livestock on it. So they gave us like 6 chickens. And then I was like going to sell the eggs. But they only make like 5 or 6 eggs a day.
Yeah.
So it's like you sell a dozen eggs for like $2. And it was like, this is so stupid. I hated the chickens. And you have to feed them all the time. And then winter came. And I was like, what are we going to do? We're going to like outfit it. And like, and my dad was like, we're not spending money to do that. So it was getting colder and kind of colder. And then one night, he was like, because he would come home every day, and then my mom would be like, you got to do something about those chickens. He'd be like, I know I got to fucking do. You don't think I know how to do? I have to, obviously, I got to do something about the chickens. And then, like, yeah, it was like November, and it was like getting like really close, like where these chickens were like going to freeze to death. And then he was just like, maybe it was November, maybe it was like September. He was like, all right, one night after dinner, he was like, okay, come with me, bring your BB gun. And then I walked out, just followed him, and he had a flashlight. And we went out, and they were all sleeping, and he was like, okay, you just shoot them now.
God damn.
So then I was like, okay. And then so I shot the first one.
Sorry, with a BB gun?
With a BB gun.
Is that going to work? Was it like a
Well,
really
my dad was like, it'll
one?
Be quiet, so they won't wake up. And it was just like, ping, like, woke all of them up. And then he was like, holy fuck, get him. And then so you're like shooting the BB gun like at these like... And, like, chickens don't die when you shoot them in the fucking brain. They just keep running around. So he was, like, just grab them and shoot them. And then so the BB gun I had, you had to, like, it was already loaded with BBs. But you would have to, pull the thing back and then crank it, like, 8 times and then shoot the thing because it was air, whatever. And so I'd be, like, cranking it. And then he would pass me one. And I'd shoot it in the head and it'd just run off. And then after like a couple minutes, and it's pitch black except for a flashlight. So it's just like a SEAL team mission gone wrong. So there's just like this flashlight kind of going over the place, and then it kind of blinds me, and then he's like, there's one right there. And then he, after like two, like maybe like a couple minutes, my dad was like, all right, just fucking grab him, just grab him. And then he was like, you're grabbing them. And then there's something you do when he showed me, like, when you hunt grouse, when you shoot a grouse, you go over and they're usually still alive. And so you put their head in between your index and your middle finger, and their body's hanging out the backside of your hand. And then you spin, and then you snap your wrist or whatever. But I was like 12 or 13, so I didn't really have like the strength to do that.
Yeah.
So then I was just grabbing chicken heads, shaking and them swinging them like this, and throwing their bodies against the barn. As hard as I could, like those, like, you know, this, I don't know, it's like an Olympic sport, like they swing it and then they throw it. It was like a softball throw against the barn door. It was like wham, wham. And then so after like 25 minutes, my dad's like panting and he's like pointing at them. And then there's a couple of them kind of moving and floating around. And he was just like, don't tell your mother.
I was just going
to
say.
And then he said that, and then we went inside and washed up, and then I just went to bed.
Yeah.
And then I the next morning, my dad was like, you got to get those chickens cleaned up. And then I had to go and just clean up all the chickens the next morning. That was not a lot of my childhood, but like quite a few times in my childhood, my dad would be like, all right, there's a dead animal, or there's an animal that needs to be dead. Get a bag. And he would give me all the instructions, and he'd tell me where it was, and I'd be like, okay, let's go. And he would be like, let's. And then he'd be like, I told you where it is. And then I'd have to go scoop a cat off the street and then
God
bury it.
Damn.
And then not tell my sister. And she's like, where's Bruno? Where'd Bruno go? And my dad would look at me, like stare at me. He'd be like, we don't know where he went, do we? And I'd be like, no, we don't know where he went. And I just flash back to me burning the fucking
probably
cat that
ran
I've known
away
for
to a nicer home.
Yeah.
Dude,
known this cat for 8 years. Anyways,
that coupled with him like building you had the funniest dad on the planet.
My dad's still the man.
That's so
my dad
awesome.
Is the man. Like he's not. He's sick.
That is so
he's
funny.
He's so fucking funny.
Building you weapons and like killing stuff with you. That is so funny.
Yeah.
God damn it! That you have.
One time,
dad.
I'm gonna blow this story. One time, we went out hunting and. And I just like never like, and it's still now, I'm just like not a farm guy. I'm not an outside guy. I'm an inside cat, you know, like yeah. I like exercising and shit like that. But I just like, my dad's like the manliest fucking man. And like, I can pretend to be that, yeah. but, cause I've like learned how to camouflage myself.
Yeah.
But so we went out hunting, and so I knew like how to use guns and stuff. I don't remember how to do it now, but I had like a child's license for a gun. Like that was the first thing I got when I was 12 is like, you were like, my dad was like, you're legally allowed to have a gun.
Showing that at school.
Yeah. Minor's license. Like,
watch it, pal. Fucking,
yeah. Look out. I have a firearm. And then, so anyways, we go hunting, and then like me and my buddy, who like also liked books, like we mostly just liked walking. We like we liked walking,
trolls by the river,
hanging
kind of
out,
guys.
Talking about like dragons and stuff.
Yeah.
And then we came back, and my dad was like, "I'm going out for one more look, just one more quick one," because I didn't realize like what hunting meant to him, which was like, oh, it doesn't have to be in his life anymore. So he just wanted one more look, and then he shot a moose, and then so he like sped back after we heard the gunshot, and he's like, "We got this thing." So we go, and it takes us like an hour to get it out because it's like on a cup, like an old cut block. So there's like new, there's like, it's like a year old. So there's a lot of like stumps and shit. So we have to like drag this like 800 fucking pound animal like to a point where we can get it close to the quads and like, and or like we'd get the quad, and we'd like hook it on, pull it into like pull it a bit, and then we'd have to like lift the quad, and like it was just ridiculous. And none of that matters. But we're gutting the moose, and my dad's like, I'm like, what do I do? And he was like, well, you gotta get the shit out of its ass. And I was like, okay, how? And he was like, okay, I'll just don't puncture the stomach. That's one thing. And he's like, you just gotta get in there and get the shit out. And I was like, how? And he was like, how the fuck do you think? And I was like, and he's like, yes. And I was like, okay. And then I like put a glove on, and he was like, don't ruin a glove. And I was like, okay. So I took the glove off, and I'm like looking at him, and I'm like have my hand at its butthole, and it's hot. And my dad's like yelling at me. He's like, we're losing daylight here. We gotta get this fucking animal out. And then so I do it. I put my arm in it, and then I'm pulling shit out of its butt. And I really hope no one I know hears this, but this is at the time that I just started fingering. I had two fingers under my belt, I think. And then so knowing what that felt like on a finger sense was like, yeah, it's that. It was that for your arm.
That's crazy.
And so I couldn't stop thinking about how it felt like a huge
pussy.
Yeah. I mean, I only had two. It's like, I'm not saying that moose ass is pussy.
No, but I get what you mean.
I'm just saying at the time, it's that's hot. What, I was like, this is hot and warm and a body. And that's the only other experience I've had with another body with hot and warm.
It was like the third time you were inside something. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
First time, arm.
How deep in your like elbow?
Like down, like halfway to my elbow.
Damn. God damn.
And then so I'm like scooping it out. And after like 4 or 5 minutes, I'm like gagging. And I'm like, I want to stop doing this. And then my dad just doesn't say anything. And then so I like wipe my hand off. And I'm like, I'm going to stop doing that. And he just doesn't say anything. And I'm like, fuck, I fucked up. And then so I just stand there. He finishes gutting it to the point where we can move it onto the, because it's dark now. And then we move it onto the quad, bring it to the truck. And we didn't talk about it ever again.
Whoa.
Until I brought this out. I was like doing stand-up. I told this at an open mic. Bombed. And I talked to my dad after, and I was like, I've been trying to do that. I was like, did I have to do that? And he was like, no. No. He's like, it's just a small intestine. You just grab it and you do that. You pinch it. Like once you cut the stomach open, like the belly, you cut the belly open and you go to the small intestine, you pinch it and you squeeze like a tube of toothpaste and it just all comes out.
Damn.
And so my dad left that for like 4 years.
He let you just fist this moose.
Yeah. And then not laugh, not tell anyone about it, never cut the tension.
God.
On the joke.
Damn.
How funny is that?
Your dad is the man.
It's the funniest thing ever.
God damn.
Yeah.
So did you find out later like why he had you do it like that, just as a goof?
It's because it's funny.
Okay.
It's funny. I think he said like, I didn't know if you were gonna do it or not, and I'm like, you screamed at me.
You screamed at me to do it.
Of course I'm going to do it.
And he was like, oh, I didn't think you would like actually do it. And I was like, I kept checking with you and you kept yelling at different points to do it.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Damn. That is so funny. Damn.
Scooping poop out of a moose's butthole.
That is so
funny. There you go.
Yeah, I was just about to say we should wrap this.
Wrap it on up.
Thank you very much for coming.
Dude, you guys are the best.
You're the best.
No, you guys are the best.
Damn, look at this.
Look at that.
Ain't this cute?
Yeah.
It's adorable.
Watch out for dirt bike construction.
It's coming.
Be big.
Yeah.
It's going to be big. Thank you very much. Do you have anything you'd like to promote?
No.
No.
Your album. Your album's coming out.
Yeah, album will come out. I guess like follow me on like Instagram and like
look
YouTube.
Look out England.
Nothing up there. I'm going to England, yeah.
Watch out, all you Brits.
Yeah,
Brits,
I guess watch, keep your fucking head up.
Will
yeah,
Hannigan, Willie Hannigan.
Just remember,
on Instagram.
You're not locked in that country with them. They are locked in there with you.
Yeah, they actually probably feel that way about immigrants. I know a lot of them do. I know a lot of them do. Me and the Arabs are going to be like this.
Yes.
Like, I am very excited for, to, like, again, not chill with the whites there because they just seem like.
I'm going to see pictures of you on Instagram. It'll be you and like 15 Pakistani guys.
Yeah. All like with prayer hands.
Well, I.
Yeah.
You'll have all a white hat and everything.
Yeah. I'm hitting a hookah. It's a boomerang. It's a boomerang of me with a shisha at a shisha lounge. I just do comedy at shisha lounges. I own a shisha lounge now. I work at a shisha lounge. That's what I do.
And then you have a kid who smokes cigs at 8.
Yeah, 100%. And I'm like, bro. Bro.
They don't call them cigs over there, though.
Yeah.
It's right.
Cool. What are they? Oh.
They call them sweet treats. Mm.
They call them something else.
Sweet,
they call
sweet
them something
treat.
Real funny.
Yeah. People keep saying they're like, you know, you're going to have to learn a bunch of new words. I'm like, no, I am not.
I already know these ones.
I know all the words. I know every word. Like when they're like, oh, it's not a lineup. It's a cue. I'm like, I'm not saying that.
No.
If I have to describe every show, if I go, I was in line. And if they go, what? I'm going to go, you know what I mean.
You
fucking. You get that I'm from somewhere else and I'm not saying the way you say stuff.
Yeah.
I don't know why I'm so cagey about it. But
well,
I'm
it's
like,
way weirder to try to like blend in by like using words you don't use.
Yeah, I don't want to. I don't want to blend, but I'm like, I'm talking a lot of shit right now. I'll probably get there and be like, hello,
hello, governor,
hello, oi, or I'll come back. I'll be like, it was odd,
jolly good.
It was bad.
Get,
they
some,
did
some
not
people
like
that happens,
me.
They go to England and they get a weird, fake, semi-British accent for the rest of their lives.
Yeah,
it happens. So look out.
I'm terrified. I'm literally terrified of that.
Yeah.
So I went to Mexico once and
you
I was
came back.
Still
what's up,
saying
fuckers? What's going on? You want to step or do something, bro?
What the fuck is going on, fucker? What is that, a Buick, fucker? Nice.
Yo, you got a nice head. You don't think I won't cut that shit off?
Yo, put some fucking hydraulics on the Saab, homie.
Bro, I don't need a fucking shirt.
Why the fuck would I wash my fucking legs in the shower, bro? What the fuck?
I'm Alvarez. I'm the white Spanish champ.
Fucking A, thank you for coming, man.
Thanks for having
by.
Me.
This was fun, a damn guys. Blast.
Yeah, I hope the Patreon's fun.
Boys are going to like it.
Boys are going to love it.
Off. This will probably be a free episode.
For the
free.
Boys.
So everyone can enjoy it.
Everyone can
for
enjoy.
The people. For the culture.
For the culture.
For the culture.
Oh, I remember. Oh, nah. God damn it. I was going to tell you about the time I smoked crack.
Hell yeah.
You know what? When you're back across the pond,
yeah.
If you come back to visit,
as long as I
don't
start it there, as long as I don't start smoking crack in England,
we'll still get you on it when you're smoking. If you're smoking crack in England,
yeah. Oh, good luck catching me.
maybe
good
once.
Good luck. I'm gonna be a little too busy to hang out in a basement not smoking crack.
You're gonna get a text from me when you come back to visit. Be like, there's like 15 open jerry cans of gasoline in the Chrome Boys basement right now. Mm-hmm. You're like, what? Really?
Well, maybe once you're over there for a bit, I think I have the technology. I could beam in a guest now.
Really?
So maybe we can do a virtual one to catch up.
If I smoke enough crack, I could probably scream loud.
Yeah, we'll all smoke crack and we'll meet in the astral plane.
That would be so sick. Whoa, we fucking made it, man.
Whoa.
Whoa, what do you want to do? Let's go get some bicycles.
I think we need dirt bikes.
I actually was in a meth house once and I was like, I didn't do any. But I was just like, I met a guy at a gas station. I gave him a ride. He gave me some beers.
And he was like, yeah, come in. And I was like, all right. And then we went in. And he was like, yeah, this is like they trap out of here and stuff. And I was like, that's cool. And then I was in there, bikes everywhere. Everyone just looks like ghouls. And like they're all fixing bikes. And he's like trying to introduce me to them. And they look like people who have burns, you know, where they don't have eyelids. Yeah. Where they're just like, they look fucked up.
Yeah.
And then so then they were like, and they would like turn lights off. Like if you turn lights on to go down the hallway, they'd be like, turn that off. And then they were working on like intricate chains and stuff. And then I was like drunk and I like sat down and I was like, what the fuck is up? And they're like smoking meth and stuff like that. And I'm like, don't even, it's not really clicking for me. And this one guy is like, takes a hit of meth and he was like, I was in the hospital and they showed me my heartbeat and it was the Nike check mark. And I was like laughing. And then I took a picture of him and I looked at the picture and I was like, oh, I shouldn't be here. Because I realized, like, if anyone saw me take that picture, I'm dead.
Yeah,
they would, like,
yeah,
literally
yeah.
eat
yeah,
my
yeah.
insides.
Yeah.
And then so I was like, yeah, I got to go.
Ledger sitting across from you.
Yeah. So anyways.
Oh, my God. We will beam you in. We'll do a
beam
crack
me
episode.
In. Yeah, beam me up.
We'll crack me up.
We'll catch up with you when you're in jolly old England.
Thank you very much for doing this, my man.
Put a rock in that pipe.
Oh, yes,
nice.
Hell, yeah.